Eli, we're here around three. First off, you're fresh off your first podium of the year.
Yeah.
You certainly look super happy now, but.
Yeah, the San Francisco was crazy. I mean, you know, it wasn't like it started out okay and then just got muddy. It was just a mess the whole day. So it was one of the gnarlier supercrosses I've, you know, been a part of. And, you know, there's parts on the track where you could literally get stuck. And we haven't had many of those supercrosses where it's like a motocross or GNCC where you're literally getting stuck in the ruts if you take the wrong line. So with that being said, it was so important for me to get on that podium because I feel like the week before, it wasn't good, man. It was just like an epic fail in my opinion. So it was frustrating. Kind of went back to some stuff that we knew and it worked in the mud as well.
Well, what was the issue in Anaheim? Was just, I like your Instagram caption, Anaheim and I don't get along.
Yeah.
But was it a setup thing? Was it nerves? Was it first race in a long time?
Yeah, it was, it's set up. It's like how I even executed my starts. I wasn't starting really up front. I couldn't go forward. I mean, it's a little bit of everything. And you got to be like 100% comfortable in race situations. I just was not. You know, I got tight, got arm pump, hands got tight, and just I was just fading. You know, just hanging on for dear life, basically. By the halfway point of the main.
Okay, so fast forward back to Frisco. What was your mindset entering the race? Do you have to kind of control your typical riding style, aggro, clutch, to make the bike last through a race like that?
You totally do. You have to manage your motor and your clutch. I can still at least manage mine. I can roll it back if I need to, you know, with the cable there.
Yeah.
All those hydraulic clutches were smoking, but it's very important to manage those situations. You got to do it because you never know what happens or when something will fail. So I'm mindful of it, absolutely, and it's that environment's totally different. It's like a low heart rate, but then it's you're using a lot of your muscles, but it is in a different way. You're kind of just wrestling the bike, right?
Yeah.
And at the same time, trying to be balanced and just stay up. And staying up is so important to not dump it and put your hands in the mud, because at that point it gets really tough.
Yeah. So we potentially have another muddy race tomorrow. What are your thoughts about that?
Well, I mean, we got to be ready for it, and you know, at least we will be ready. You know, and we know that we can race in the mud good, and then in my opinion, it'll probably be a different style, just because we're gonna start out dry, right, and it'll slowly get slicker if that's the case. But just got to run with it.
Yeah. All right. Last question. You're on the retro bike this week. Right now. Purple boots would look good. I know you said you never wore purple boots.
What is something
yet,
in your life?
But last week I was surprised to see even that people, because it's so out of the norm.
Yeah. That was, I believe it was the opening round for the St. Jude. So that was there's some pink flare in there for the Alpine Star gear. But we could forget about the purple boots. Those were Denver last year. It's not good.
But good luck tomorrow.
Thanks.